some of our customers have found useful applications for wave. One particular customer, we're transferring the material horizontally about 800 to 850 feet across building rooftops without damage. This was a problem for them in the past where they either had to move the material physically with Gaylord boxes or other means, and now they're able to do it with air and not have any damage. That's very important. The same customer also needed to get the material from that point up vertical 200 feet to their process. So as a result of wave, we were able to use wave to transfer it vertically 200 feet. And we could have actually went further, but it worked fine. They were very, very happy with it. You know, they're able to run their systems without dust generation and angel hair. So as part of our development process, we looked at wave valve placement, because that was always a concern with our customers, especially our customers in the northern climates where they have this big swing in temperatures, freezing one day. And so their concern was having compressed air system outside, inside the silo skirts. So what we did was we tested a method of remoting that valve so that you can keep the valve in maybe an area that is nearby where it has compressed air and heat, and then just run the line out to the silo and put a T in at the distribution box, and that allows them remote control of the line speeds and the wave system without having those components sitting in the cold. Our valves have been in the cold, they work in the cold, but the real concern is line freeze up with the compressed air piping that would feed that system. So we have a solution for all those types of applications. And one of the reasons we can do that is because of what we talked about before, that the material only sees air. So the air controls all of the pressures that we vary at the pickup points and also the flow pattern downstream in the wave system itself.